Hey there, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily, and I do mostly Salesforce tutorials on my channel. However, I do sprinkle in some other related software tutorials. Today, we're going to be going over how to create a stacked horizontal bar chart component, that's a lot of words, within Salesforce dashboards. So first things first, we need to make sure that we have access to the dashboards tab. I'm currently in the sales console, so you can see dashboards over here. If you do not see that, you can go to the 3x3 underneath the cloud and search for dashboards. I'm going to click on it. It'll take you to the same place. It even shows you that you're in that tab. You can go new dashboard or click on a dashboard that you've already created. I'm going to go to a new dashboard. And I'm going to call this test dashboard 2. And then you can add a description if that is helpful. If you are not the only one that's going to be viewing this, and possibly you're sending it out to a lot of people that are going to see it and check on it regularly, it'd be helpful to add a description to give some context and some history to possibly the assumptions that you made when creating the dashboard or the source reports. You can choose the folder. You can put it in your private dashboards, you can put it in a public dashboard, really whatever the purpose of the dashboard is, you're going to put it in the folder and have the sharing already done. I'm going to click create. And from here, I have a blank canvas. I'm going to go to component, plus component, and we need to select a source report. So this is a part of a series I am doing on my channel for dashboarding and reporting, and we have created a bunch of different reports as a part of that series, and you can go ahead and go back. The playlist will be linked, the first link in the description box. But as far as creating this stacked horizontal bar chart, you do need to have a report that has at least one grouping, either by row or by column, and I happen to know that the matrix report does. So I'm going to select that one. And from here, we are able to go and select stacked horizontal bar chart, and you'll be able to see the data move a little bit. We can choose our y-axis and see how the data is broken up. We can also change the x-axis if there are options. We can stack it by different things. We can stack it by created by or account name. I'm going to leave it at account name just so then we can see how the data can be best visualized. And please, if you're doing this along with me or within your own dashboard, feel free to mess with these settings. You can display units as different things depending on what you have. So if you have billions of, let's say, dollars on the line that you want to report on and create a dashboard from, then please choose the billions. Again, just mess around with this and make sure that you're creating the best for you. You can change the x-axis range. So if you wanted the middle number to be 40 and you actually wanted the top number to be 60, you could do that by changing the custom number. But I'm just going to keep it automatic. We can change the decimal places if you're working with decimals. We can change sorting and have it be ascending or descending. We can also sort as a secondary thing. You can add a custom list, show as many groups displayed as you want. I'm going to change the title of this. I think it's really helpful to change it. It'll default to the source report name, so it's not the matrix report component. This is going to be the horizontal stacked bar chart. You can also add a subtitle if you find that's helpful. If this is going to be going out through to a lot of people, that will also be helpful and can give you more context than just the description would. Same with the footer. We can change the legend position. For some components, it makes sense to have it on the right side. Other components, it makes sense for it to be on the bottom. Particularly for this, I think it makes sense to be on the bottom. Just so then you can see the visualization a lot easier. You can also change it from light to dark. I like the contrast of dark, so I will save it there. We can hit save and then done. And it takes you to be able to view this dashboard. From here, you can refresh it, edit, subscribe, download, save as, create a new dashboard, and delete this dashboard. We can also go down here at the very bottom of our component. We can click on it and it'll send us to our source report, which can be really helpful. And oftentimes you'll see a lot more information quicker than you would just looking at a dashboard. So let's say we wanted to know how much the Burlington Textiles opportunity was going to give us. We'd click on it. And we see Burlington Textiles, how much the amount is worth. I'm going to go back to our dashboard, and that is how you create a stacked horizontal bar chart component for a Salesforce dashboard. Again, this is a part of a series on dashboarding and reporting within Salesforce. So if you are interested in that, again, that'll be the first link in the description down below. Thank you so much for joining me. Like if you found this helpful, subscribe if you're feeling generous, and I will catch you in the next one.